I want to introduce you to you now, a very lovely lady. For the last several years, Wendy Griffith has been a staple on the CBN airwaves. You know her as a reporter and an anchor on our program here. But behind the scenes, Wendy is much more than that. She is a prayer warrior.
Throughout my career, I've had the privilege of covering breaking news around the world, from 9/11 to Hurricane Katrina to a hostage crisis in the Philippines. I've found myself on the front lines of some of the biggest stories of our time, including Israel's 2006 war with Hezbollah. While filming a stand-up, we ran for cover as the bomb siren warned us of an incoming Katyusha rocket. I've interviewed many spiritual leaders and covered massive prayer events around the globe and sat down with celebrities and famous people.
You are the number one cable news talk show host on the planet.
By far.
And very humble.
That's something I got to work on. That's why I go to church. I got to work on a humility thing.
But the one constant through all of these events was prayer before air.
Well, she's here. She's lovely. Wendy, it's so good to see you. We appreciate you being with
us. It's wonderful to be with you.
You're enjoying your time at CBN. I hope you are.
Almost 13 years, Pat.
You're kidding.
Can you believe that?
I remember you were just a little girl when you came
here. I don't know about that. Started in 1999. You know what was happening in January of 1999 was the impeachment trial of Bill Clinton.
Is that?
That was my first assignment.
Oh, boy. Not a fun time. Mm-hmm. Maybe.
Well, it was a bittersweet time as a journalist. I mean, D.C. was a very dark place at that time.
Well, it's still dark, honey. I'm glad you're here. Praying the news. That's the title of your book. And you have all these stories. Tell us some that you prayed through.
Well, you know, praying the news, Pat, what does that mean? You know, I report the news. What does it mean to pray the news? We're responsible, Pat. As believers, we're responsible for the headlines. As the church goes, so goes the nations. The Bible says so. You know, in 2 Chronicles, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, then I will hear from heaven and heal the land.
That's right.
So how do we pray the news? Well, Jesus said, pray my kingdom come, God's kingdom come, God's will be done. If something is grieving your heart, that's a clue to pray the news. There's a story, Dr. Vincent Sinan from over at Regent University, perfect example. He, back in the 80s, he was burdened by communism, and he said he wanted to see it collapse, but he said, you know, at that time, remember the Cold War, that seemed impossible.
I mean,
it seemed, how could that ever happen without war? God told him to pray that it would just collapse from within without war. He did that. A couple months later, he turned on the TV, and the Berlin Wall was falling down.
Yeah.
My co-author and great friend Craig von Busick has this great story where he ended up in D.C. unexpectedly, right across from the White House. The Holy Spirit said, I want you to walk around the White House and pray that everything hidden will be made known.
Come on.
So he did it. And you know what the Secret Service were watching? You know, he's laying hands on the bars there. But what happened was a couple months later, the Monica Lewinsky scandal broke. These are examples of where we partner with God to change the headlines.
I'm sure Bill Clinton is thrilled at Craig. The lid came off. Well, you were with me, or I was with you, whichever, over in Israel. We had quite a time during that war. I told them, they said, well, can you come? I said, as long as you keep the war going, I'll come over.
I'll never forget, Pat, we were on a bus going through Kiryat Shimon in northern Israel, and you said, I want to hear the boom boom. I said, me too. You know, we had that in common. You know, you're a journalist at heart. We want to be where the action is.
Exactly.
And it was exciting. I mean, there's no doubt about it. The war was winding down then. But I remember I kept Psalm 91 out, opened on the car seat. Do not fear the terror by night, nor the Katyushas that fly by day, or the arrows that fly by day. And I just thought, Lord, you know, David wrote that 3,000 years ago, but this is, I'm holding on to this promise today.
You remember, we were being interviewed by Fox, and the Katyushas were coming in, and those guys were running around with those silly little helmets and those flak jackets, and I was out there in a leisure suit trying to do an interview. It was so funny.
The siren, the bomb siren went off at the same time the Katyusha was whizzing over our heads. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
And then I think we got a picture of you where in the book, it's in the book where you can see where the Katyusha hit the mountain behind you in the smoke.
Smoke was coming up.
Smoke was coming up. And, you know, but didn't you feel the peace of God?
Absolutely. I wouldn't worry one bit.
I wasn't either.
Either, yeah.
You know, and people say, how can you go into a war zone where you're playing Russian roulette with the Katyusha rockets? But we felt the peace of God.
Totally.
I remember enjoying a nice chocolatey type dessert with you and a Coca-Cola at a little restaurant in Kiryat Shimona during the war.
We didn't care. Well, you're terrific. Praying the news, ladies and gentlemen, when you have a news person who isn't just reporting it, she's praying it. You got anything coming up, by the way?
Another great example of praying, of changing the headlines, is Manchester, Kentucky. You know the story where their headline, Pat, was painkiller capital of the nation.
Right.
They were desperate, you know, and they got together, a few pastors prayed. God told them to march through town.
Right.
They did, in a cold, wet rain a few years back. They said, held signs saying, drug dealers, get saved or get busted. God showed up when they marched and has not left that town. George Otis has said it's the only town he's ever been to that has had true God transformation, from the drug community to the political sector. Even the land came back. The black bear, the elk, the fish. They got awarded best water in Kentucky, Pat, because they prayed.
Yes.
They prayed. They saw their headline. They're not the city of dope anymore.
No.
They're the city of hope.
Hope.
And it says so. When you drive into town, it says Manchester, City of Hope. And it all happened because of prayer. So this book is about, first of all, we have authority to pray.
That's right.
And we need to use that tool that God's given
us. Stop wringing your hands and worrying about what's going on and pray. This book's called Praying the News. It's available nationwide. Appreciate Wendy Griffith. She's a marvelous addition to all of us, this family here.